He has a Windows laptop, which is very nice, but you know what's a lot nicer? The ability to reboot this laptop into Kali Linux. So I've installed both Windows and Kali Linux onto this laptop, and I can dual boot between them. So I can boot into Kali, or I could boot into Windows. So once again, what I've done here is taken a Windows 11 laptop and installed Kali Linux on the laptop, and then I have the ability to either boot into Kali or boot into Windows. In this video, I'm going to show you how to do that. I've got another laptop here, and I'll show you the full process. Same principle applies if you're using a Windows 10 laptop as an example. Very easy installation. Okay, but without further ado, let me show you how to dual boot between Windows 11 and Kali Linux. Okay, so here's my Windows 11 laptop that we're going to set up for dual booting. We need two pieces of software. We obviously need to download Kali Linux. So on the kali.org website, I'm going to click on download. I'm going to go to the installer images, and I'm going to download the 64-bit installer. I've actually already downloaded that in preparation for this video. You can see it's about 3.8 gig in size, but I'll click save just to show you the full process. Next thing we need to download is Rufus. You may prefer using other software, but we basically need something to write the ISO image to a USB drive. So I'll plug this into my computer, and what I'll do on the Rufus website is download Rufus 4.2 for Windows 64-bit. You could use the portable version, but I'm simply going to use that version of software. I'll double click on the exe, say yes to run it. What it's done is pick up my USB drive. I've actually previously installed Kali on this drive, so that's why it's showing up with Kali. I then need to select my ISO image. So I'm going to select the image that I previously downloaded. What I'll do actually is stop the current download because I've already got it downloaded. Very simple. You download the ISO image for Kali, you download Rufus or some other software, and then what you do is you select your USB drive and you select the image. We're told that we could either use an ISO image or DD image. I'm going to use ISO. And then we warned that everything will be overwritten on the USB drive. I'm okay with that, so I'm going to press OK and write the image to the drive. You can see the drive is being formatted, and then the image is being written. Okay, so while that's been done, what I'm going to do on Windows is right-click on the Windows icon and then go to Disk Management. So here's my Disk Manager. At the moment, I don't have any free space on my hard drive because the Windows partition is taking up all the free space. What I'm going to do, however, is right-click on my Windows NTFS partition, and I'm going to click Shrink Volume. Now, you don't need that much space to run Kali and Linux in general, but what I'll do here is specify about 60 gig. That gives us plenty of space. You could obviously allocate much more space, or perhaps as little as 25 gig. More is generally better. I am only going to specify 60 gig here, so I'm going to shrink the Windows partition. This is the amount remaining for Windows, and that's more than enough. I'm going to click shrink. So there you go, 58 gig in size. Now, you could obviously give a lot more space to Kali, especially if you're not doing a lot on Windows. But just for this demo, I've got about 178 gig for Windows and 58 for Kali. I'll just show you this. If you want to allocate more here, you could shrink this volume again. So what I could do as an example is allocate another 10 gig and click shrink. And there you go, 68 gig of space is now available. We just need to wait now for the writing to the USB drive to complete, and then I can show you what you need to do to go into the BIOS of the computer. Now, there are two ways to do that. You could power this down using Shift, and I'll show you that method in a moment. Otherwise, you just need to reboot the computer and then press the right control key. This depends on your laptop. So this is an Asus laptop. I could just do a search for Asus BIOS key, and we're told here to enter the BIOS configuration on an Asus laptop, press and hold F2 while the computer isn't powered on, and then press on the power button. That depends on your laptop. For instance, with this Dell laptop, different key is used, F8 if I remember correctly. So you just need to find out which key to use for your specific laptop, or you can do the following, which I'm going to show you in a moment. Either method works. Okay, so the writing to the USB drive has completed. I'll click close. I'll close this. And then what you can do is press the shift button down, click on power, and click restart. Okay, so notice what happens. We can go to troubleshooting, advanced options, and then we can go to UEFI firmware settings, or if you're old like me, the BIOS, and click restart. Okay, so there's a few things that you need to do here. First thing we need to do is go to security. So this really does depend on your specific brand of laptop and laptop, but I'm going to select secure boot, and you're going to want to disable secure boot. Make sure that you have that disabled. Now, as always with these videos, you do this kind of thing at your own risk. For this to work, you're going to want to disable secure boot. So that's something that you're just going to have to decide to take the risk on. But that isn't really a concern of mine. So I have disabled secure boot. Next thing we want to do is we want to specify the order of boot. So I want to set the computer to boot off the USB drive first. So I'm going to set that up. Make sure that you disable your secure boot. Set your boot order to USB, and then I'm going to say save and exit. And I'm going to say yes. So hopefully what should happen now is the laptop should reboot and then boot off the USB drive. Okay, so there you go. We can decide how to install Kali Linux, either using graphical installation or just a standard installation. For this example, I'll just go with the standard installation, so no graphical install. Graphical is nicer in some ways, but I'll just use the standard installation. Okay, what language are you going to use? I'm going to use English. Which country are you in? In my example, it's United Kingdom, so I'll specify that. Which English are you going to use? British English. Okay, so we need to connect to the internet to download files. So in my example, I've got this laptop connected via a USB to the internet, so using Ethernet. You could connect to a Wi-Fi network if you like, but I'm going to just specify Ethernet. So I'll press enter. It's getting IP addresses from DHCP. Next thing you need to do is specify the host name. So in my case, I'll specify Kali. Domain name I'm going to specify is none. Now, again, this is not best practice. I'm just showing you a demo. I'm going to specify username of Kali. Password is going to be Kali, just like you get when you download the pre-built VM. Again, not an example of good passwords, but just to show you the demo. So I've put in my username, I've put in my password, I've verified the password, and now it's going to start the partitioner. Now, to keep it simple, I'm just going to use guided, and I'm going to use the largest continuous free space. Press enter. I'm going to install all files in a single partition, so keep it simple. And I'm going to say finish partitioning and write changes to disk. If you're happy with the changes that are listed, say yes. It's now installing the base operating system. Okay, we now need to select the software to install. So you can just go with the defaults. I'm going to show you a problem I've had and a way to solve that, but I'm going to simply go with the defaults and press continue. Notice this issue. So I've had that on a few of these installations. So I'm going to select and install the software again. And what I'm going to do to get this to install is uncheck top 10 and uncheck default. I found that I had problems. It might be something with this image or something else that's causing problems. But if I unselect those two options and then go continue, the installation passes, and then I can just install all the software later once this is installed successfully. Okay, there you go. Installation is complete. So it's time to boot into your new system. Make sure that you remove the installation media so that you boot into the new system rather than restarting the installation. Choose continue to reboot. So what I'll do now is remove the USB drive and then press enter to continue. You can see the system is rebooting now. And there you go. Now we have the option to boot into Kali or into Windows. It automatically boots into Kali. And I can log in. So my username, Kali, password, Kali. And I've successfully booted into Kali Linux on this laptop. Now, before I update the computer, I just want to show you that it works properly. So I can restart the Kali Linux installation. And if I press down arrow now, I can select Windows. And as you can see there, it's starting to boot into Windows. And there you go. We've got a Windows installation. So I can log into Windows. So there's Windows 11. And once again, I can simply restart Windows and I'll be able to boot into Kali Linux. So in other words, boot from one operating system to another. I've now got dual booting working on this laptop. I'll press enter to go into Kali. I'll show you a few more things in Kali just to get your installation up to date. You don't have to do this. You may want to get things updated. So I'll boot into Kali again. And what I'll do is start a terminal. So I'll type sudo apt update to update my references. I'll put in my password. Now, one of the things you may want to do is upgrade your Kali Linux installation. Or as mentioned, you may want to install the default packages. So what you could do is simply paste that in here, and that will allow you to install the various tools that are missing. Again, that's not required. Depends what you want to install. I had issues during my installation process where it didn't want to pass the installation when I selected the default tools and top 10 tools. So this allows you to install those. You probably also want to upgrade your Kali Linux installation. So you may want to do that first before installing the default packages. I'm not going to bore you showing you all those options now. This is simply going to install the software. What you can see is I have got various software tools installed. This will allow me to have more tools than what I've got here. And it's probably something that most people want to do. Okay, so there you go. I've shown you how to get Kali Linux running as a dual boot with Windows 11. It's not that difficult a process. Just be aware of secure boot. You're going to want to turn that off. Very important to do that in the BIOS. Make sure that you've got enough disk space to install Kali. Make sure that you've got a USB drive. You can download the image and then install it from the USB drive. Now, if you enjoyed this video, please consider subscribing to my YouTube channel. Please like the video and click on the bell to get notifications. I'm David Bomble, and I want to wish you all the very best.